Good morning, everyone. Very warm welcome to you. Warm welcome to those here on video and today to those who are outside, because there are some folks outside in the car park. You will guess this here is not me about to start a concert. You'll be very glad to hear that. It's for the amp outside. So this is our carol service for this year and we hope you enjoy it. The Christmas Day service is in church here at 10 o'clock on Friday morning, a family service, and then on Sunday the 27th, the service will be online only because there's not enough time between the two services, so please look online for the service for Sunday the 27th. Let me just begin with our bidding prayer, so let's bow our heads. We've come together as the family of God in our Father's presence to celebrate the great festival of Christmas. In this service, we hear and receive the good news of the birth of Christ, and we offer to God our thanksgiving in the joyful singing of carols. As we gather together in the name of Christ, we pray for the world he came to save, for the church, that it may be enabled in our generation to surrender anew to God's sovereignty and will, and to bear the good news of God's love to a needy world, for the world which is already Christ's because he died for it, that all its people may recognize their responsibility and may be inspired by the message of Christmas to work together for the establishment of justice, freedom and peace everywhere. And for all in special need, the sick, the anxious, the lonely, the fearful, and the bereaved, that the peace and light of the Christ child may bring hope and healing to all who sit in darkness. We commend all whom we love or whom we have asked for our prayers to the unfailing mercy of our Heavenly Father, and say together, as Christ himself taught us, the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Amen. We have our first reading from Isaiah chapter 9, verses 2, 6, and 7. The people walking in darkness have seen a great light, and those living in the land, the shadow of death, a light has dawned. For to us a child is born, to us a son is given, and the government will be on his shoulders. And he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Of the increase of his government and peace, there will be no end. He will reign on David's throne and over his kingdom, establishing and upholding it with justice and righteousness from that time on and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord Almighty will accomplish this. Thanks be to God. As we remain seated, we sing our first carol, Once in Royal David's City.
Thank you.
Our second reading is from Luke 1, chapter 1, verse 26 to 38. In the sixth month, God sent the angel Gabriel to Nazareth, to a town in Galilee, and to a virgin pledged to be married to a man named Joseph, a descendant of David. The virgin's name was Mary. The angel went to her and said, "Greetings, you who are highly favored. The Lord is with you." Mary was greatly troubled at his words and wondered what kind of greeting this might be. But the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary. You have found favor with God, and you will be with child and give birth to a son, and you are to give him the name Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. The Lord God will give him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over the house of Jacob forever. His kingdom will never end." "How will this be?" Mary asked the angel, "since I am a virgin." The angel answered, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. So the Holy One to be born will be called the Son of God. Even Elizabeth, your relative, is going to have a child in her old age, and she who was said to be barren is in her sixth month, for nothing is impossible with God." "I am the Lord's servant," Mary answered. "May it be to me as you have said." Thanks be to God. We sing the carol, "Hark the Herald Angels Sing." Our third reading is from Matthew chapter 1, beginning at verse 18. This is how the birth of Jesus Christ came about. His mother Mary was pledged to be married to Joseph, but before they came together, she was found to be with child through the Holy Spirit. Because Joseph, her husband, was a righteous man and did not want to expose her to public disgrace, he had in mind to divorce her quietly. But after he had considered this, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream and said, "Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary home as your wife, because what is conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit. She will give birth to a son, and you're to give him the name Jesus, because he will save his people from their sins." All this took place to fulfill what the Lord had said through the prophet. "The virgin will be with child, and he will give birth, to a son, and they will give him the name Emmanuel, which means God with us." When Joseph woke up, he did what the angel had commanded him and took Mary home as his wife. But he had no union with her until she gave birth to a son, and he gave him the name Jesus. Thanks be to God. I'm going to ask Bobby to sing for us now. She's going to sing "O Holy Night."
Stars so sweetly gleaming.
Thank you, Bobby. Our fourth and final reading for this morning is from John chapter 1, beginning at verse 1. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was with God in the beginning. Through him all things were made. Without him, nothing was made that has been made. In him was life, and the life was the light of men. The light shines in the darkness, but the darkness has not understood it. There came a man who was sent from God. His name was John. He came as a witness to testify concerning that light, so that through him all men might believe. He himself was not the light, so that he himself was not the light. He came only as a witness to the light. The true light that gives light to every man was coming into the world. He was in the world, and though the world was made through him, the world did not recognize him. He came to that which was his own, but his own did not receive him. Yet to all who receive him, to those who believe in his name, he gave the right to be children of God. Children born not of natural descent, nor a human decision, or a husband's will, but born of God. The Word became flesh and made his dwelling among us. We have seen his glory, the glory of the one and only, who came from the Father, full of grace and truth. Thanks be to God. As we consider God's word, let's just bow our heads for a moment and commit our time to the Lord. Father, thank you for your word of truth. Thank you, Lord, that you have spoken, that you have sent your Son. Help us, Lord, to hear your word this morning, to understand it by your Holy Spirit, and to apply all that you're saying to our lives. For we ask it in Jesus' name. Amen. As you look at your family, if it's like mine, I'm sure you will agree there are times when family life can be a real drama. Every day things happen. Things that mean our lives will be filled with real joy or thrown into absolute turmoil. In all of this, it is very easy to become overwhelmed. In knowing all these things in our own lives, we can understand Joseph and his response to Mary's news of a baby. Given the culture in which they lived as a couple, betrothed but not yet fully married, this explains Joseph's fear. And so as we consider this passage of Matthew 1, we see firstly, Gary, could you move the slides on? We see firstly Joseph's fear calmed in the purpose and plan of God revealed. It says, because Joseph, her husband, was a righteous man and did not want to expose her to public disgrace, Joseph feared for Mary's future and indeed her safety. The consequence for her in all of this situation was potentially life-threatening. The law said that she should be stoned to death. However, amid his fears, God intervenes to assure him that this is a work of the Holy Spirit in God's purpose for mankind, because this child Jesus will save people from their sins. This explains the announcement to the shepherds later on in Luke chapter 2, where we're told the birth is good news for all people everywhere. Through the baby, Jesus, salvation has come. Therefore, Joseph did not need to fear. God was in control of his life and indeed Mary's life. And equally, therefore, he was in control of the life of the world through each and every generation, including you and me today. All that means, secondly, the Lord can be trusted because his promise does not fail. And we see this as the prophet Isaiah is quoted in Matthew verses 22 and 23. All that was happening had been foretold. God was fulfilling his word through Joseph and Mary. That was a comfort to Joseph, but equally for you and me too. If your life seems out of control, if you are fearful, look to God's word. Look to the promise that he has given you, the promise that will not fail. Those promises of the past fulfilled mean that we can trust the promises of God's word to us through Jesus. That is, of life eternal and a resurrection hope. This is absolutely central to the Christmas story. It isn't separate. It isn't something that's added on later. Your salvation comes through the promised virgin birth fulfilled in Mary. Finally, therefore, we see God speaks and Joseph responds in faith, verses 24 and 25. When Joseph woke up, he did what the angel of the Lord had commanded him and took Mary home as his wife. But he had no union with her until she gave birth to a son, and he gave him the name Jesus. See, God had spoken into Joseph's situation and he believed God's word to him. But more than that, we see that that belief followed through into his living. He was living out his faith in all that the Lord had revealed to him. Believing God's word made a difference in Joseph's life. His mind was changed and the course of his life was changed too. He was faithful to the Lord in his life. And we see that in the passage as it tells us. He gave him the name Jesus, just as he had been told to do. The challenge to a people today, this Christmas, is the same. Believe God's word given to you. For those outside the kingdom of God, and indeed the people of God, that means that we need to repent and to believe the good news of our salvation won for us as the Saviour dies for you and for your sin on the cross of Calvary. And for those of us who are already walking with the Lord, believing in him, we need to trust God's word all the more and know that in the uncertainty of the days in which we live, God is in control. Christ will return. And your place with him is prepared in the kingdom that will never pass away. Our hope is in him and in the assurance of his word. Therefore, live out your life in faith, trusting Jesus, proclaiming him as Lord, being a faithful witness to the fact that God's promise is true and salvation is available in the good news of the gospel this Christmas. Therefore, celebrate this Christmas in the wonder of our Lord and God, who loves you and who sent his son to be born of a virgin, so that in the words of John 3 and 16, whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have eternal life. Thanks be to God. Praise be to his name. Let's bow our heads and we'll pray. Father, we thank you for the wonder of the Christmas story. Help us never to become complacent, to become overfamiliar with it, that it loses its meaning and its impact. We thank you, Lord, that you have loved us so much that you sent your Son. Give to us this Christmas the joy and the blessing of faith in him. And know that whatever happens in our lives, you are in control. You are Lord and you are God, both now and forevermore. Amen. And we continue in prayer. Heavenly Father, we pray amid all the joys and festivities of this season, we may not forget what Christmas really means. That you love the world so much that you gave your only Son, who was born to be our Saviour. Lord, teach us by the example that you gave us in your poverty, in the poverty of your birth. Teach us not to become so engrossed in material things that we lose the sense of true value of life. Spirit of love, inspire us with generosity towards people in misfortune and distress. We ask these prayers, giving glory to God in the highest now and forevermore. We thank you, Lord God, for your word, spoken of the old through prophets and apostles, and recorded for us in Holy Scripture. And most of all, for your final word, spoken to us through your Son, Jesus, made flesh for us men and for our salvation. Grant that through the written word we may behold the glory of the incarnate word, who is now exalted to the right hand of majesty on high, and to whom we ascribe all praise and dominion forever and ever. Amen. We praise you, Lord God, for the good news of Christmas, for the coming of your Son to redeem mankind. Let it be good news for each of us at this time, as we open our hearts to your love and welcome Jesus as our Saviour. Then show us what we can do to pass on the good news to others, that they may share our joy and give thanks with us for your unspeakable gift in Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. And finally, we pray for peace. O God, we thank you for the message of peace that Christmas brings to our distracted world. Give peace among the nations, peace in our land, peace in our homes, and peace in our hearts, as we remember the birth at Bethlehem of the Prince of Peace, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. We sing our final carol for this morning. O come, all ye faithful.
Thank you.
we conclude with our prayer of blessing. Let us pray. Go in peace. The wisdom of the wonderful Counselor guide you. The strength of the mighty God defend you. The love of the everlasting Father enfold you. The Prince of Peace be upon you. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you this night and forevermore. Amen. Take care. God bless. Have a great Christmas as best we can in the present circumstances. Stay safe. And we look forward to seeing you very soon. Remember the Christmas Day service, 10 o'clock. Take care. God bless. And the wardens will show you out at the appropriate time. Thank you.